Hello, welcome to The Plot Malaysia. This is our 8th episode. This is a show for the fans.
By the fans.
All right, absolutely fantastic. Today is going to be a fantastic show. We're just going to be discussing stuff about our 90s hero because it's the International Week. So Hari, what do you think about that?
We're giving away our age with this round, but fair enough. You know, let's just do it. We put ourselves on the line here, so it's fine. But yeah, I'm really excited about today's show, guys. I'm sure you are as well, Ram. We're talking about our heroes from the 90s. These are the guys that we were brought up with. These are the guys that drove us to like football for the first time. We fell in love with football because of these guys, many of these guys. So yeah, really looking forward to the show today, guys. We've got some really exciting content and we want you to participate. This show is about getting you guys to participate as well. So yeah, very exciting. So Rob, firstly, man, how's the weekend been? Gone well?
Weekend has been fantastic, you know, just gearing up for the show. And of course, my wife's birthday is tomorrow. So we're doing something special today. So yeah, well, before that, we want to actually do this show as much as possible to talk to everyone and share with them what we do. So what Hari said earlier, we're talking about our 90s hero, right? Right? Okay.
90s hero, guys, that's dedication for you right there. His wife's birthday is tomorrow. He still makes it a point to do the show. That's all. That's what it's all about.
I have a support as well. So thank you so much. Okay.
Awesome. Guys. awesome, Ram. So listen, this is how it's going to work, guys. So Ram has got thinking over the last few days. I've been thinking over the last few days. What we've done is very simple. We've picked out our dream team from the 90s. Right. So let me just explain to you how this works. And we want you to participate, like we said as well. But basically, we have chosen our best 11 players. So starting lineup. From players who were very active in the 90s or were at their peak in the 90s, right? So they've got to have been active in the 90s or in their peak in the 90s. And yeah, it's not as simple as it sounds, guys, because there's a catch to this. And Ram's going to tell you what the catch was.
Yes, thank you very much, Hari. The catch is, every one of you, if you want to participate, your players have to be, each of your players can only come from the country once. That means you can only pick a player from the country once. That means if it's from France, you can't pick two or three players from France. It only has to be one. So each player from one country. That's where, you know, it's going to be very interesting. So if you guys want to participate, leave your comments down below. Tell us your team and we will be more than happy to actually share in the next show as well. So yeah, Hari, am I right about that? Did I say it correctly?
Absolutely, man. Spot on, bro. So listen, I'm really excited to see what your team is. I don't know what your team is before today. It's the first time. And I think you haven't seen my team as well. So let's get started, Ram. You go first.
Okay. So let's see. Let me pull off my team over here. So I want to go straight through, right? Hurry from goalkeeper right up to the strikers.
Absolutely. Correct? Yes. Yep.
Okay. So starting off as a goalkeeper, you know, I love this guy, the big Dane, Peter Schmeichel, you know, from Denmark. Okay. And then I'm going to go moving to the center backs first. You know, Paolo Maldini from Italy. All right.
Good pick, man.
I'm gonna go with Jaap Stam from Holland or Netherlands. Okay. My right back is interesting. You know, I'm going with Cafu from Brazil. Okay.
That's Brazil gone. Yep.
My left back is Xavier Zanetti from Argentina.
Okay.
Okay. All right. My central midfield, my DM role, I'm gonna give it to Hidetoshi Nakata. From Japan.
Wow. So you've got an Asian player in there. Good job, man. Yes.
Asian represent.
He was the poster boy, man, for the Asians back in the 1998, I think it was.
And I think, you know, it's the best time to pick him because I really, really think he's an amazing player. Of course, right wing, I'm going to go with David Beckham because his crosses are amazing, from England, Giggs will be on the left-hand side for Wales. So there's a bit of a gray area over there, but it's okay. It's England-Wales, so it's fine. All right. My attacking center midfield, I'm going with Zinedine Zidane from France.
It's a good choice as well. So let me get your midfield right. Yeah. So it's David Beckham, Ryan Giggs, Zidane, and Nakata, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Correct. Correct. And my two forwards, because I'm playing a 4-4-2, my two forwards will be Andrei Shevchenko from the Ukraine.
Oh, man, he was on fire back then.
He was on fire. And I'm going to go with someone that I think, you know, has been a wonderful player as well. George Weah from Liberia.
Liberia, what a player, man. From AC Milan. Exactly. Guys, if you don't know about George Weah, watch his YouTube clips, man. Thierry Henry said, right? Thierry Henry in an interview once said, he was his inspiration because he played with him when he was a kid. And George Weah was in Monaco at that time, and Jordi was just coming up. And so he was his hero. He said he's never seen a striker like him. And if you haven't watched anything about George Weah, guys, watch. He was African Footballer of the Year. He was World Footballer of the Year. The only African to win World Footballer of the Year.
Yes.
And, you know, I think one of his goals is worth watching. You can YouTube it. His best goal for ever from George Weah. He ran from his penalty box right up the other end and scored a goal. Yeah, George Weah, man. Absolute star, man. Yeah, George Weah. Awesome, man. That's actually a very strong team, Ram. I'm worried now.
Thank you, Hari. Thank you. I'm excited to hear about your team. Let's see how this your team fares. Okay. So, guys, you know, you got to tell us, you know, between me and Hari, which team do you think is the stronger? If we were to go head-to-head, which team do you think will win? And we are also excited to know about your team. So, Hari, go ahead.
Okay.
Tell me.
Listen, let me put a situation or a condition here based on how I put this team together. All right.
Okay.
So these players, many of these players you'll see were from the 1994 World Cup, or had a big World Cup in the 1994 World Cup. And the reason I've chosen them is because that was the first World Cup I watched. And that's what really got me into football. All right. So they are like my, these are the guys I remember. They are my heroes, basically. Right. They got me into the World Cup. The other thing is, you guys may be surprised I've left certain players out, but that's fine. Everyone's got an opinion. The reason the reason I've done it is because I've based my selection on players that I watched a lot of times. So, you know, there may have been certain players in there who were well-known at that time, but we didn't have access to some of those matches, for example, from the Italian league or Spanish league at that time. So I didn't watch them enough in my own eyes. So I didn't go with them. I went with players that I had seen more and that I really liked in terms of their technique, their ability and what they'd done, right? So yeah, basically, I mean, it's players that I like. So, you know, screw your opinion. This is my opinion, guys. But yeah.
Liverpool fans like to talk a lot. Go on, Hari.
Okay, so this is my team. I start with the goalkeeper. It's José Luis Chilavert from Paraguay.
Oh my God. Whoa, that's
so
a good
you
one.
Guys know
free
this.
Kick taker.
Yes, the goal-scoring goalkeeper from Paraguay. He used to score goals from free kicks, penalties for Paraguay. They had a free kick in a promising area. He was their free kick taker and he had a fantastic goal scoring rate from free kicks. And at the same time, he was a very good goalkeeper as well. So for me, he had to be in there. He was brilliant. José Luis Chilavert. Okay. In defense, you'll be surprised, Ram. I've got two players the same as yours. So in right back position, I've gone with Cafu.
Oh, wow. Okay. All right.
And the reason is because, again, people may say, you take Cafu from Brazil, that's your Brazil tally gone. But Cafu was an unbelievable right back, man. He used to go up and down, solid defensively, really good in the attacking half, played for AC Milan, was a top, top player. So I had to get Cafu in there and right back.
Cafu in, yeah.
At left back, I went, so I'm playing three-man defense. So the left central defender, you can say I went with Zanetti, Javier Zanetti as well.
Okay, that's interesting.
And,
oh my
and
God.
And again, quality player, man. He was captain, I think, for his team as well. The league team he played for. He went up and down. He played for Inter Milan. Was a top, top player. Played lots of games. Fantastic player, man. Up and down the pitch, brilliant. So I went with Zanetti. And then in the center back, middle of center defense, I've gone with Fernando Hierro from Spain.
Oh,
Real Madrid man. Real Madrid man who was captain for Spain as well. And Madrid, I think. What a player. Really solid defender. Played a hell of a lot of matches for Spain and Madrid. So he had to be in there. Now, my midfield is going to shock a lot of people. It's a very attack-minded midfield, guys. Okay. Similar to Ram, actually. Attack-minded. what I've gone with. I've gone with my all-time favorite central midfielder, Rui Costa.
Oh, Portuguese.
Manuel Rui Costa from Portugal. This guy, guys, was brilliant, man. He had dribbling ability to glide past people, score brilliant goals. He was a chain smoker at that time, but still a class player. Brilliant footballer. People remember him from AC Milan, but that was the later part of his career. The prime part of his career was when he was playing for Fiorentina. In Italy. And he used to be the supplier for Gabriel Batistuta. The two of them were brilliant together. So, and I've always been a fan of Rui Costa. He used to have his socks near his shin, you know, near his shin guard, right on top of his shin guard. Really low class player. So I went with Costa. And then I went with another one of my favorite players. If you guys don't know, I spent 4 years in Africa as a kid in Nigeria. And this guy was the best Nigerian to play the game. Ram knows who I'm talking about here.
I know.
He had dribbling ability. He played for Paris Saint-Germain. Ronaldinho said he learned a lot of skills from him and he was his almost his idol in PSG. He then went to Bolton and he lit up the Premier League.
In Bolton, let's say it together, bro.
In Bolton, the fans used to sing, he was so good, they had to name him twice. And the reason they named him twice was his name was JJ Okocha.
JJ Okocha, yeah.
What a player. Dribbling ability, brilliant African player. Used to get past people, had terrific skills, good free kick on him, long range shots. Okocha was the man, man. So I had to go. And guys, again, something you guys want to watch. He scored a wonderful goal in his when in his early years. And I think you've seen it, Ram. For Frankfurt, I think it was. And he was playing against the keeper, Oliver Kahn. He dribbled past Kahn twice. Oliver Kahn. Dribbled past three defenders. And then he scored the goal. Brilliant goal. And Kahn was just left on the floor, basically. So Okocha has to be in
JJ.
There. And then I went with a player that people may surprise. People may say, why didn't you go with someone like Michael Laudrup from Denmark, who I thought was a brilliant player. But again, the reason I didn't choose Laudrup, I didn't watch him play enough. For me, I didn't watch him play enough. And this guy, who I chose, was a hero from the 94 World Cup for me. One of those players that made me love the game and want to watch the game more. He played for Romania. He was called the Maradona of the Carpathians. And his name is Georgi Hagi.
Georgi Hagi, I remember that guy.
What a player, man. Georgi Hagi. Yeah, man. He scored a world-class goal against Colombia in the 94 World Cup. They called him the Maradona of the Carpathians. He had ability with the ball. He played for Galatasaray most of his career, but people may not know he actually had a short stint at Madrid and Barcelona. Just a top player, man. Dribbling ability. And if he used to have a fantastic left foot. He used to score brilliant long-range goals. So I had to get Georgi Hagi in my team, man. That's why I went with him. Again, a hero from the 94 World Cup for me. Now, this is going to shock everyone. My choice from France. People will say, it has to be Zinedine Zidane, bro. And then I put a lot of thought into it. I was very close to picking Zidane, but I didn't pick Zidane. I actually went with a player that I enjoyed watching more. Because we used to get the Premier League a lot on TV. And apart from watching Liverpool games, this was my second choice match to watch this guy play. All right, he used to play for Tottenham, Newcastle. I don't know if you know who I'm talking about, Ram. Johan Cruyff in 1999 said he, at that time, was the best player in the world at that point of time. When Man United won the treble in 1999, he was voted the PFA Player of the Year in England. All right?
Yeah, I know who you're talking about.
Wanted by Barcelona at one point in time as well. Flamboyant guy, long hair, looked like a model, but his ability with the ball was only one man, David Ginola. So I had to go
David
with
Ginola, yeah.
I had to go with David Ginola, man. Used to love watching him play. Ability with the ball, unbelievable. Strong as a bull. Used to run with both left and right foot. Score wonderful goals. I don't know if you like.
I enjoyed watching him in Spurs when he was playing for Spurs. Yeah.
Yes, man. What a player. I'm sure you liked him as well, Ram. But he was one of the heroes for me, man. I used to watch Tottenham games just because of him. So I had to get Ginola in there. Now, my forward line, because I picked three defenders, I went with three attackers in attack. Again, a lot of it is inspired by the 94 World Cup. So, on the left-hand side of attack, I've gone with a Bulgarian who took his team to the semifinals of the 94 World Cup, played for Barcelona, was a star in the dream team of Barcelona under Johan Cruyff, none other than Risto Stoichkov. Stoichkov. The man
his name is so powerful.
Yes. No. What a man, what a player. Dribbling ability, used to get in the box, used to score long-range free kicks, took Bulgaria single-handedly to the semifinals of the World Cup and lost to France. I think, was it France? No. Who did they lose to in the semifinals? I think they lost to Italy.
Italy.
In the semifinals, yeah.
Probably,
and talking about Italy, the other player I have, the other striker I have, he's the divine ponytail. The man who missed a crucial penalty in the World Cup final against Brazil. But he's the one who got Italy there. He was outstanding in the knockout round, scored in every knockout round pretty much to get Italy to the final. Was a wonderful player in Italy. I still think he's one of the best Italians to play the game. Played for Inter when they had Ronaldo and Ivan Zamorano. He played with them. He played for Juventus for a while. But his best ever goal, and guys, I want you to watch this. I think he's one of the best goals technically ever scored that I've watched. Was when he was playing in the later part of his career for Brescia. And he scored the goal against Wanda-Sar, if I'm not mistaken. I think they were playing Juventus. Long ball from Perlo. And he singed with one foot. He controlled the ball and just one touch, controlled the ball coming out of the air and took it past the keeper in just one touch. and scored an empty nine.
Oh.
The Divine Ponytail, they're making a documentary on him now on Netflix. It's coming out in May. Yeah. Watch it. It's Roberto Baggio. Right?
So let's watch.
I had to go with Baggio.
Good choice, man.
I'm left with one striker. The one striker I'm left with is a player that I enjoyed watching in the Premier League era. It was brilliant in the 90s. Went into the 2000s as well. Played under Arsene Wenger. He's got a statue at the Emirates. He's not Thierry Henry, though, because he's not Thierry Henry, but he's my favorite player. One of my favorite players of all time. Scored lovely goals, brilliant touch and ability. That one of the best Premier League goals ever scored today was him against Newcastle. Ram, you remember the goal?
Yes, I do.
He turns Davidas. He flipped the ball one side and he went the other side and scored.
Yeah.
It's Dennis Bergkamp, man.
None other than
Dennis Bergkamp. So that's my team, guys. I think it's a brilliant team. I think it will beat Ram's team. But yeah.
I think it's really brilliant, bro. I mean, your team has got a lot of the wonderful players that I used to enjoy watching as well in the Premier League.
And yours is the same, man. Some fabulous players. It's nice. This, I say, you get really passionate about this because these guys got us to living the game, man, and watching the game.
Tell us. Guys, tell us, which team do you think will win if they go head to head with each other? My team or Hari's team? And if you think you have a better team, please comment down below. You know, and remember the catch, one player from one country. So you can't go more than that. You know, leave your comments down. We want to see it. We want to actually mention our next show. And of course, you know, it's going to be awesome. Right, Harry?
Awesome, man. Looking forward to seeing what your teams are, guys. And yeah, I mean, this was fun for us to put together. It took us a bit of time.
Really fun, man.
We really enjoyed it. It was a fun exercise. So I hope you guys have the same fun out of it. Now, before we leave you guys today, I mean, I know we are focusing on the 90s heroes today, but we can't leave without talking about the Champions League draw round. The draw just happened on Friday, the quarterfinal draw. What are your thoughts on the draw, man?
Oh my God. You know, when I looked at the draw, I was like, each and every game looks very promising. I think there's no easy one here. I think all the teams have equal chances of actually going through. So it's going to be a real mouth-watering clash for all these four games because I really, really, really can't wait to watch all these games. You know, what do you think, Harry?
I agree, man. I think that all the games are fantastic, going to be closely fought. But I think the two standout ties are, I think the two standout one, which is Bayern versus PSG, which is a repeat of last year's final. And then there's Real Madrid-Liverpool, which I think are really for Real Madrid-Liverpool, we're looking at it as revenge. Ramos injured Salah. We lost that game. It's time for Salah to take revenge. So looking forward to that tie.
We'll see about that, Harry. We'll see about that. Because just want to let you know, guys, you know, for Liverpool and, of course, Real Madrid clash, just before, of course, a few days before the game, we're going to have a Real Madrid fan on the show to have a go at Harry.
It's going to be head-to-head, man. So, there's only one winner in that.
It's going to be... Yep. We'll keep you guys posted on that. Stay tuned to our show. And, of course, you know, we'll go on to that. But, yeah, Harry, I think Liverpool and Real Madrid will be a good game because I do personally think, although I am not a Liverpool fan, but I think Liverpool are pulling a few surprises in the Champions League. So I have a feeling it might go your way, Harry. I don't know why. This feeling.
Man United fan has a feeling it's going to go our way. It's definitely our year. All right, Ram. Very quick one, man. Who do you pick to go through from all the four ties and who's your eventual winner? I want to know.
So Man City versus Dortmund.
Yep.
I'm going to go with Dortmund. I think Haaland has, I don't know, he's just got something up his sleeves. I think he will do something good. I think they will go through.
Yep.
Porto and Chelsea, I think it's time for Chelsea to make a mark. I think Chelsea will go through.
Yep.
Bayern and Paris, I'll go with Bayern. Honestly speaking, man, yesterday they just won against Stuttgart. They were 10 men down.
And they still won again.
And Robert Lewandowski scored a hat-trick. You know, it was amazing. So, Bayern to go through. Real Madrid, Liverpool. Yeah, I think Liverpool. Honestly.
Interesting. My picks, I'm going with... I'm actually going with PSG to beat Bayern. I got a feeling Mbappe is going to get one over them. So, PSG to go through. Man City, Dortmund. I think Man City are going to be too strong. So, I think Man City will go through. Porto, Chelsea. I think Chelsea will go through. Because they're in good form under Tuchel. Liverpool, Madrid. What do you think I'm going to say, man? It has to be the
obviously
Reds.
You're going
to
say mighty, Liverpool.
The mighty, mighty Reds. So Liverpool will go through. And my eventual winners, you go first, Ram. Who is going to win the Champions League for you? The whole thing.
This year, the whole thing, I think is going to be a surprise. I think I'm going to go with Dortmund. I think Dortmund will win it.
Liverpool. I mean, I can't choose any other team. It's going to be Liverpool that wins the prize. So yeah, looking forward to that. Looking forward to the quarterfinal games. I think they are the first week of April or so when it kicks off. And yeah, like Ram said, we're going to have a Real Madrid guest on the show to go head-to-head with me as we talk about both our teams and who's going to come out on top. Listen, guys, we can't leave the show today without talking about the second-tier European competition. I don't like talking about it, but I have to because we've got a United fan on the show who is hosting the show. So, Ram, what are your chances, man? Who do you draw? Granada in the Europa League? Who's going through?
Granada. Of course, United. What do you think I'm going to say, man? Obviously, United are going to go through. And obviously, United are going to be the winners of this competition.
Who do you think they're going to face in the final?
The final is going to be, I think it's going to be the easy one. I think it's going to be Dinamo Zagreb. I think they're going to go through all the way to the final. United is going to meet them in the final. And we're going to beat them.
I think it's going to be a repeat of one of those FA Cup games, in the past. I think it's going to be Arsenal, Man United in the final. I got a strong feeling about that. But anyway, guys, leave your thoughts. Okay. We want to know your thoughts as well. This has been a fun show for us, putting together this show, putting together our 90s teams and having a go at each other. And we want you to have fun as well along the way. So leave us your thoughts, give us your teams. And yeah, we'll hopefully read out some of these teams in our next show. Ram, looking forward to the next show, man. The next show is going to be fun, man. You got to tell the guys what's coming up next.
Yep, guys, I just want to keep this, exciting for you as well, because the next show, we're going to be having a special guest all the way from Singapore, okay, who is a Spurs fan, okay, and he's basically a host of the Spurs Nation TV on Facebook. So if you're a Spurs fan, and I don't know if you're following those channels, but if you're not following that channel, you can please go ahead and do it on Facebook. The host of that show, BC, or Ng Boon Chen, he will be on our show discussing about Spurs. And of course, it's going to be a fun one. So stay tuned. Remember to leave your comments, subscribe to our channel. And of course, hit the like button as much as possible. Right, Harry?
Awesome, guys. Fun. Guys, going to be awesome. Really looking forward to talking to him about Mourinho and how they went out to Dinamo Zagreb as well. But it's going to be a fun show, guys. Listen, keep the subscribers coming in. Continue subscribing. Give us a like. Comment. We look forward to hearing from you guys and on what we can talk about moving forward as well. And we're going to endeavor to bring much more interesting and awesome content to you. All right. Definitely. Awesome. Ram, listen, pleasure, man. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. Say happy birthday to Yadni for me as well.
Thank you so much. I sure will.
And have a good time, man. Cheers, guys. Signing off. Cheers, guys. For the fans.
By the fans. Cheers. Cheers, guys.